वेलकम टू ज्योग्राफी क्लास फॉर क्लास 7. टेक आउट योर ज्योग्राफी बुक लेसन नंबर 2 पेज नंबर 21.
वी हैड स्टार्टेड लेसन एटमॉस्फेयर. वी हैड डन इंट्रोडक्शन, कंपोजिशन ऑफ एटमॉस्फेयर, गैसेस दैट प्रेजेंट इन द एयर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर. लेट्स रिकॉल द टर्म्स एटमॉस्फेयर, weather, climate, temperature.
Let's discuss the new terms that you are going to do in this topic. Lithosphere, the part of the earth covered with land. Temperature, degree of hotness or coldness. Ocean currents, movement of water in an ocean in a specific direction. Altitude, height above the sea level. Today is day 2. In today's video, we will study structure of atmosphere. Learning outcomes of the topic. To describe the different layers and the importance of the layers of the atmosphere to sustain life on the earth, draw the diagram to show the structure of the atmosphere. Let's start with the topic, structure of atmosphere. Based on temperature, the atmosphere is vertically divided into 5 layers. These layers are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere. Let's understand with the help of diagram. Structure of atmosphere. Our atmosphere has several layers like troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, exosphere. Now we are going to discuss the first layer, that is troposphere, where 80% of air which we breathe is available. Almost all the weather conditions are occur here, like rain, hail, snow, fog, smoke. All the weather conditions are here. It extends up to the height of 13 kilometers. After troposphere, we have the next layer, stratosphere, where ozone layer is present, which absorbs the UV rays of the sun and keep our earth suitable for living. 90% of air is present here, but almost with the zero water vapor, it extends up to the height of 30 kilometers. It is a calm layer and good for aeroplane flying. After this layer, we have the next layer, mesosphere. It is a coldest layer because after ozone layer, in this layer, the temperature start decreasing. In stratosphere, temperature is high due to ozone layer because it traps the heat of the sun. After this layer, in mesosphere, temperature start decreasing. The temperature falls up to minus 95 degrees Celsius. It extends up to the height of 80 kilometers. Meteorites burn up here. Next layer is thermosphere. Is also known as ionosphere, where radio waves transmission is there. Due to reflected back of these radio waves, the electrically charged ions fused in atmosphere and sudden lights come in the sky. The northern lights are called aurora borealis and southern lights are called aurora australis. After thermosphere, we have exosphere. This is the uppermost layer of the atmosphere that merges into the space, and the temperature is very high, up to 1600 degrees Celsius. Let's read about all the layers now. Structure of the atmosphere. Like the lithosphere, part of the earth covered with land. The atmosphere is also found in different layers. Thus, our atmosphere has a layered structure as the concentration of different gases varies with the height. The denser and the heavier gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide are found near the earth's surface, while the lighter gases are found at the higher altitudes. Altitude, height above the sea level. Based on temperature, degree of hotness or coldness, the atmosphere is divided vertically into 5 layers. These 5 layers are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. Troposphere. The term tropo is derived from the Greek word tropos, which means turning. This is the layer which immediately surrounds us. Yes, student, this is the layer which immediately surrounds us, where 90% air is available, all the weather conditions are there, rain is there, hail is there, smoke is there. Its chief characteristics are, it is the most important layer of the atmosphere. The air we breathe exists here as the dust particles and water vapor are present at the lower levels. All the weather phenomena like rainfall, fog, hails take place in this layer of the atmosphere. So this is the layer where all the weather conditions are there. 90% air is available. An exchange of heat and moisture amount of water vapor present in the air due to exchange, the ocean currents plays a significant important role in determining the climatic condition near the sea coast. Sea coast means area near to the sea or ocean. Let's discuss how ocean currents plays an important role in determining climate of a place. The ocean surface currents that function to move large amount of heat across the planet and redistributing heat and water vapor to all parts of the world. The ocean currents typically driven by surface winds can have a huge impact on climate. For example, northwestern Europe, in spite of its latitude, it is not a frozen land because Gulf streams of eastern coast of United States transports warm water to northwestern Europe and keep the Europe warm in winter. This sphere extends from the Earth's surface to an average height of 18 km. This is the extension, 18 km. The pressure in this layer decreases from 100 millibars to 200 millibars with increasing altitude. The temperature generally decreases with altitude at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius for every 1000 meters. The moisture concentration in that atmosphere also decreases with height. For this, I have drawn one diagram. I will show you and describe this lines on the diagram. Temperature generally decreases with altitude at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius for every 1000 meters. What is this? This is called lapse rate. When you go high, with the height, with the increase in height, temperature decreases. Right? Like there is a relation of pressure and temperature. When the pressure is more, the temperature is also more. Like pressure is more at the surface near to the earth, but as we go up, the pressure also decreases. Pressure decreases. With the decrease in pressure, also the temperature decreases. This is called lapse rate. Like you can see, here the temperature is 20 degrees C. Before starting up, I should take up all the altitude. Why it is there that height above the sea level? What is sea level? Why we are taking sea level for calculating the height? Sea level why? Because is equal. The sea level is equal because all the sea and ocean, they are intermingled with each other. We are not taking land because land is not equal everywhere. Somewhere land you can get high mountains, somewhere you get plateaus, somewhere you get the plain lands. So land is uneven. We can't take land. That's why we are taking sea level, because sea level is equal and we are taking it as zero because due to intermingling the sea level is everywhere equal. Right? And this is the height above the, always we measure the height in the sea levels. Like if we are here, why we are going in summers to the hill station? Due to that, because with the increase in height, the temperature decreases.
Like if we are here at this place, A place, the temperature is 20 degrees C. When you go up 165 meter, then the temperature will be 19 degrees C. More 165 meter, the temperature will decrease 18 degrees C. Like after 165 meter, the temperature is decreasing by 1 degree Celsius. Here you can learn this term. In your book it is given, 1000 meter height, the temperature decreases of 6.5 degrees Celsius. You can learn both the terms because both the terms are same. If you take 165 meter high, the temperature will decreases with 1 degree Celsius. If you take 1000 meter high, the temperature decreases of 6.5 degree Celsius. Pressure less, then temperature is also less, also moisture less.
Let's read further. The troposphere ends at the tropopause. Tropopause is the upper limit of troposphere where temperature is generally 57 degrees Celsius. After this tropopause, the temperatures start increasing. Let's start with the next layer, stratosphere. This zone lies above the tropopause and extends up to 20 km. This is the extension. It extends up to 20 km. Temperature in this layer increases with height. It increases after every 20 km. After every 20 km, temperature is start increasing. In this zone, there is a high zone, ozone concentration that has formed its own layer. Yes, in this zone, ozone layer has formed its own layer. Ozone, we have already read about this gas. It is the ozone oxygen O3 molecules which absorbs the UV rays of the sun and which makes the earth protect from the ultraviolet rays from the sun. Ozone is a form of oxygen. Its formula is O3. Which protects the living forms on the earth from the ultraviolet rays from the sun. This layer is ideal for flying aeroplanes. This is ideal for flying aeroplanes. Why? Because there is no weather phenomena like rain, hail, storm that is there in troposphere. So this is very good for flying aeroplanes because of absence of clouds and weather condition in this zone. Let's read about the another layer, mesosphere. This is the thermal layer lie above the stratosphere. It extends up to the height of 50 to 85 km. This is the extension. Temperature in this zone decreases with height. As we have already learned in stratosphere, the temperature is increasing due to ozone layer. But in this layer, the temperature starts decreasing. At the mesopause, we have already learned about tropopause. Now it is a mesopause. Mesopause is the upper layer of this zone. The temperature falls to minus 95 degrees Celsius. It is the coldest layer. Meteorites burn up here when they enter the Earth atmosphere from the space.
Let's start with the next layer, thermosphere. It extends from mesosphere to exosphere, that is 80 km to 600 km. Temperature in the lower layers of this zone is stationary or isothermal. The temperature rises rapidly with height. With high temperature start increasing. The chief characteristics of this sphere is formation of ionosphere by electrically charged particle known as ions. Ions are the electrically charged particles which is there in this layer. These charged particles reflect outgoing radio waves. They reflect the outgoing radio waves, so that is why this layer is very good for radio transmission. Radio transmission can be possible in this layer on the Earth's surface due to this layer. The radio waves transmitted from the Earth are reflected back to the Earth from the ionosphere. These waves are again reflected back to the Earth's surface from ionosphere. The reception of radio signals reflected back from the ionosphere at night is also very
good. The northern lights called aurora borealis and southern lights are called aurora australis. These are aurora borealis and aurora australis. Aurora borealis are the northern lights in the northern hemisphere, and aurora australis are the southern lights in the southern hemisphere. The northern lights are called aurora borealis and the southern lights are called aurora australis, are also produced by the electrical activities of this layer. Due to radio transmission, the ions are released in the atmosphere, and due to that, the southern lights come in the sky. They are visible at the night in the northern hemisphere, the part of the earth above the equator, and southern hemisphere, the part of the earth below the equator, respectively, making a fascinating phenomenon. Let's move to the next layer, exosphere. It is the uppermost layer of atmosphere which gradually merges into the space. There is no definite boundary between atmosphere and space. Air is in exosphere is extremely thin. The light gases like helium and hydrogen are found here that flows into the space. The heavier gases are found in the lower layers, and the lighter gases like helium and hydrogen are found, or they are floating in the atmosphere. The temperature is always high at 1600 degrees Celsius in this layer. This is the end of the topic. I hope you understood the topic. You are able to do some exercises and terms. Draw the diagram which I have shown in the beginning.
And I will come with the next video. Thank you.